Hello children, I'm back. How's your day? Good? Fine. I'm sure all of you have done your homework. The profile of Sarojini Naidu and the answers to the questions given. Haven't you? Fine. Let's come back to the poem now. Before that, I would like to show you a video of how the condition of India was when Sarojini Naidu wrote the poem. Shall we see it? What is the theme of this video? It tells us about the life of the people when Sarojini Naidu wrote the poem. No wonder why the poet wished for a land of truth, love, and peace. Let's come to the poem written by Sarojini Naidu, Song of a Dream. Once in a dream of a night I stood, lone in the light of a magical wood. Soul deep in visions that poppy-like sprang, and spirits of truth were the birds that sang, and spirits of love were the stars that glowed, and spirits of peace were the streams that flowed in that magical wood in the land of sleep. Lone in the light of that magical grove, I felt the stars of the spirits of love gather and gleam round my delicate youth. And I heard the song of the spirits of truth. To quench my longing, I bent me low by the streams of the spirits of peace that flow in that magical wood in the land of sleep. There are some words which you find difficult in the second stanza. Shall we just discuss it? So here is the first word, grow. A group of trees. Marakootam. Topu. Second, we have two words, gather and gleam. Gather and gleam. Yes, the poet feels that the stars above are coming towards her, around her, and gleaming brightly. Maybe the poet feels the people of India are coming together for a free nation. Here we have the next set of words. Delicate youth. Mrudulamaya, lolamaya. That is delicate. Now, youth. What is the specialty of adolescent children like you? Youth is a period where you are energetic, lively, full of dreams and visions. And it is the period where you can come up with your dreams. It is a time when we are likely to go astray. വഴിതെറ്റി പോവാൻ ഏറ്റവും സാധ്യതയുള്ള കാലഘട്ടമാണ് യൗവനം. ബട്ട് ദർ ഇസ് എ പോസിറ്റീവ് വേ ടു ഇറ്റ്. യു ക്യാൻ ചാനലൈസ് യുവർ എനർജി ഇൻ ടു സംതിങ് ഇൻ ടു ഫുൾഫില്ലിങ് യുവർ ഡ്രീം. Next, we have quench my longing. Quench. What do you do when you are thirsty? You drink water and quench your thirst. So quench is shamipikya. When you are thirsty, you drink water and you quench your thirst. Appa endana daham shamipikya. Now here the word is quench my longing. Longing means what? Desire. So quenching your desire. What is the desire over here for the poet? To have a free India. That is the dream and desire of the poet. So here, the poet's dream, her vision of fulfilling, of getting freedom for India. You have gone through the second stanza of the poem, right? Now let me ask you some questions based on the stanza. First one, what do the spirits of love do? Correct? The spirits of love gather and gleam round the poet's delicate youth. Second question, how does the poet quench her longing? The poet quenches her longing by bending low by the streams of the spirits of peace. Are you ready for the third one? What is the magical wood referred to here? Yes, that's right. The magical wood is a perfect land of ideal values. It stands for her motherland where truth, love and peace coexist. What do the spirits of love do? The spirits of love gather and gleam round the poet's delicate youth. How does the poet quench her longing? discuss the relevance of Sarojini Naidu's dream in the present scenario. Do you feel there is truth, love and peace in the nation now? Yes or no? It's a personal answer. Every day you hear and come across incidents of injustice, discrimination, oppression and violence. So you must have heard it, you must have read in newspapers, you must have heard in news about the condition of our country today. So compare it with the situation of the poet's time. Okay, so that is a personal work and you are going to write based on it. Okay children, so you got an idea about the stanza. In the first stanza, we have seen the poet has seen the spirits of truth, love and peace. She is wishing for a land wherein all these qualities exist. In the second stanza, we see that she is feeling and touching the spirits of peace, truth and love and wishing for a country wherein all the people have the vision of truth, love and peace. It's a beautiful poem with a variety of vision. In the first stanza, we have identified the rhyming words and the rhyme scheme. Now, in this stanza, you are going to find out the rhyming words and identify the rhyme scheme. Let us identify the visual images in the stanza. Visual images in the second stanza. Magical grove, stars, woods. Auditory images. Songs, streams that flow. Alliteration, lone in the light, stars of spirits of love, gather and gleam, songs of spirits of truth, streams of the spirits of peace. Okay. I'm sure you got an idea of the poem. Children, go through the lines and frame a picture in your mind. It's time for the assignment now. The first assignment is to prepare an appreciation of the poem. Do you know to write an appreciation? We begin with an introduction. In the introduction, we write something about the poet. Then comes the main theme of the poem, the dream of a free India set up on the purity of life, love, truth and peace, and free from all evils of hatred, dishonesty and disharmony. In the second paragraph, you write the literal meaning or paraphrasing. What is paraphrasing? You take each stanza, read it well, and what idea comes to your mind, you write it as a paragraph. Okay, if you have two stanzas, you will be writing in such a manner. Is that clear? Paraphrasing. Now, third comes imagery. In imagery, you have images. Haven't we learned five sense organs, five images? But in this poem, you have just three images. Which are they? Visual image, auditory image, and olfactory image. You write those and write the examples. Next is the lyrical qualities. The rhyme, the rhythm, alliteration, all are a part of this. After that, we write the poetic devices. Which are they? Simile, metaphor, personification, and so on. After that, you are going to write the message conveyed in the poem. The last part comes the conclusion. Now, self-evaluation of the poem. Which is the line you like the most? Why? What is the theme you understood from the poem? Everything, whatever you liked in the poem, will come in the self-evaluation part. Hope you got how to write an appreciation of the poem. So, you write an appreciation and send it to your teacher. Another work is to answer the questions we have discussed. Children, after the appreciation, answering the question, there is one more activity for you. If there is any activity remaining, consult your teacher and complete it. Is that okay? My dear children, hoping for a better generation who can transform our nation where peace, love and truth exist. Today, you are going to see the Malayalam version of the song. Let's enjoy it.
ഒരു സ്വപ്നരാത്രിയിൽ മായാവനഭൂമിയിൽ ഒരു സ്വപ്നരാത്രിയിൽ മായാവനഭൂമിയിൽ നിന്നു ഞാനേകാകിയ നിന്നു ഞാനേകാകിയ സ്വപ്നരാത്രിയിൽ മായാവനഭൂമിയിൽ നിന്നു ഞാൻ ഏകാകിയ ആത്മാവിനായിരം പൂക്കൾ വിരിച്ചു നീ ആനന്ദ നൃത്തമാടി ആത്മാവിനായിരം പൂക്കൾ വിരിച്ചു നീ ആനന്ദ നൃത്തമാടി പാടി പാടിയ പാട്ടുകളൊക്കെയും സത്യത്തിന് ദേവസ്വരങ്ങളായി പാടി പാടിയ പാട്ടുകളൊക്കെയും സത്യത്തിന് ദേവസ്വരങ്ങളായി നക്ഷത്രശോഭിതം ആകാശം സ്നേഹത്തിന് ദേവതമാരായി ജ്വലിച്ചു നിൽപ്പൂ നക്ഷത്രശോഭിതം ആകാശം സ്നേഹത്തിന് ദേവതമാരായി ജ്വലിച്ചു നിൽപ്പൂ അരുവികൾ പാടിയ പാട്ടുകളൊക്കെ ശാന്തി തന മന്ത്രങ്ങളായിരുന്നു അരുവികൾ പാടിയ പാട്ടുകളൊക്കെ ശാന്തി തൻ മന്ത്രങ്ങളായിരുന്നു ശാന്തി തൻ മന്ത്രങ്ങളായിരുന്നു സന്തരാത്രിയിൽ സ്നേഹത്തിൻ താരകളായിരം പൂത്തിറങ്ങി നിത്രതൻ വാസന്തരാത്രിയിൽ സ്നേഹത്തിൻ താരകളായിരം പൂത്തിറങ്ങി തരളവിലോലമെൻ യൗവനമാതെ പ്രണയ പ്രശോഭിതമായിരുന്നു പ്രണയ പ്രശോഭിതമായിരുന്നു സത്യത്തിൻ ദേവ